Oh, hello, Jahn.
Hello.
When did you arrive?
I've been here for a while.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Hello, Jahn.
Hello.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Long time no seen.
Indeed.
Cheers, cheers, buddy. Hey guys, we are back with another board game video. So Jahn, you can do the honors. What are we playing today?
Today we are playing Horrified.
Ah! Horrified.
Yeah.
So, let us show you guys the box. Da-da-da! So, tell us all about Horrified.
Yeah, so this is a board game based on old school horror, 30s, 40s.
Yeah, so we have a board game where you're fighting Dracula, Frankenstein, the werewolf, the mummy, Invisible Man.
Yeah.
And Frankenstein, right?
Yeah, one little note on that. They actually put a note in the rulebook that they know that Frankenstein is the professor. But the villagers have started calling them Frankenstein, so they just call them Frankenstein.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Just get it out of the way.
Yeah.
Also, if the Dr. Frankenstein is the Frankenstein monster's father or creator, then wouldn't Frankenstein's monster technically be called Frankenstein for his last name?
Ooh.
Huh?
Ah,
that's something to think about.
Very clever.
Hmm. Yes. Anyway.
Yeah, anyway, so this is a very simple, fun, I would say almost like a family-friendly board game.
Yeah.
And it's a co-op game. We are all playing as different characters, like the professor here, and like you have detectives, all sorts of characters working together, moving around in this town, trying to save civilians and try to stop the monsters. Basically.
Yeah, that's, I guess, essentially it.
And one of the cool things I like about this game is that every time you play, you can choose different monsters.
Yeah.
And the different monsters have different, like, mechanics and you have different ways you have to fight them. So that adds also a little bit variety to the game. Yeah. So, Jahn, what did you think of the game?
I really liked it. It's pretty simple to learn. It's quick to set up.
Mm-hmm.
And you still have enough variety in both the monsters you're fighting and the characters having their different abilities and all that. So it doesn't,
it has some replayability.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It sort of changes every time you play it.
It's always nice to have some co-op games. It's nice to have different monsters that you can use to get a bit variety as well, as we mentioned.
Yeah.
And the game is as follows. Like, you have, every character has a certain amount of actions. You can move, you can pick up stuff on the map, you can fight the monsters, and you can give stuff to each other, and you walk around, do objectives, and then it's after you do your turn, it's the monster's turn. And it's fun because you have a lot of cool civilians that also walk around and you have to save them and take them to safe locations. And if you're a horror movie fan, you will recognize these civilians. You have, for example, Renfield over here. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything else to say about this game?
Yeah. I mean, even though the game is pretty simple, all of the characters have their own unique abilities.
Mm.
And all of the monsters have sort of their unique challenges.
Yeah. Unique attacks as well.
Yeah, that's also true. So things can happen differently, sort of depending, or the game will play differently, depending on what characters you play and what monsters you have. And monsters sort of get defeated in different ways.
Mm.
So for instance, when we played against the Wolfman, and you have to find like
the cure
for lycanthropy, and you have to give it to him, And for Dracula, you have to smash his coffins around the around town, and then you have to fight him.
Yeah.
And defeat him.
And you can adjust the difficulty as well by having more monsters in one game or fewer monsters. So that's pretty cool too. So if you want a bigger challenge, you just add more monsters.
Yeah.
Yeah. There are cool details as well. Like even the items you find, all the items have a location where you put them. And it makes sense. Like you find, I don't know, like you find in at the barn.
Yeah, there's a gun.
There's a shotgun. And you have also like a pitchfork that you can find there. So the items are, they make sense. And yeah. I like the design of the town. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
One thing I also like, I don't know why, but this kind of reminds me of a very, very simplified version of Arkham Horror.
Yeah.
In the game mechanics.
Yeah, and a lot of the ideas is
yeah.
the same.
Mm.
The theme is, of course, a little bit different, but it plays in a similar-ish
so way. If you have plans to introduce your kids to Arkham Horror, but they're not ready yet, you can start with Horrified.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's a good sort of gateway
game. Absolutely, and a very fun game to play around Halloween. And
yeah.
That's what we're all about.
That's what it's about.
Yeah,
yeah. yeah.
So if you want something horror-themed, but also family-friendly, this is a very nice game.
Yeah. Pick it up, play Horrified.
I don't know if there's anything else to say about this game.
No, I think we covered it.
Yeah.
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 All right. Thanks for watching, guys. And have a nice Halloween. Don't get too scared. Don't eat too much candy.
But do get a little bit scared. And
yeah.
Do eat
some candy. And we'll see you guys very soon.
We will.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Ah.
Delicious cup of coffee.
I love that coffee. I love coffee. And I also love lamb. I love lamb and coffee.
Yeah. Did I invite you to the pants party?
I got the invitation.
Yeah, because 64% of the time people miss it all the time.
Yes, but it works every time like the other percentage. Jeg følte vi var inne på noe frem til Rafa kom inn. Rafa ødela alt. Det går bra.
The game plays.
Hello!
Hello!
Welcome in!
Yes.
Welcome
in.
Ja, du er på TV. Men bare kom inn.
Det lett å glede å finne nå. Om en trannabag.
Beste oppfølgeren til, eller uoffisielle oppfølgeren til Deliverance.
Det synes jeg som en Guy Ritchie-film.
Ja, det kunne jo vært.
Det kunne vært en veldig bra Guy Ritchie-film.